Good day. Kindly follow me on my Facebook page and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you. In this video for grade 8 mathematics, we will talk about the parallel and perpendicular lines, and it consists the postulate and theorems. So, pag-usapan muna natin ano nga ba kapag sinabing parallel lines, these are the lines or coplanar lines that do not intersect. The symbol for parallel is this one. So, to check whether two lines are parallel, they must be equidistant to each other. So, nire-represent ang parallel lines or ganito yung itsura ng parallel lines. So, kung mapapansin nyo, dalawang lines na kung saan ang layo nila sa isa't isa ay magkatulad. Or kung ano yung layo dito sa baba, ganun din yung layo sa taas. And then, kung saan man natin i-extend yung dalawang lines or gaano man kahaba i-extend ang dalawang lines, ay never silang mag-i-intersect or never silang magtatagpo. So, pwede siyang paslant or paslant na pakaliwa, and then pwede namang vertical lines at pwede rin namang horizontal lines. So, we have one postulate for parallel. So, there is exactly one line parallel to a line at a given point not contained on the line. So, for example, meron tayong isang line. And then, meron daw tayong isang point. So, kung ang point na ito ay nag-form ng isa pang line, therefore, ito yung tinatawag nating parallel line. Next is the perpendicular lines. These are lines that intersect at right angles. The symbol for perpendicular is this one. So, when the intersection of segments and rays form right angles, then they are considered perpendicular. So, ang itsura ng perpendicular ay pwedeng paganito, pwede rin namang paganito, or pwedeng pa letter X, pero magpo-form pa rin siya ng letter L dito, or magpo-form ng right angles. So, there are theorems or perpendicular lines. First, if two lines are perpendicular to each other, then they form four right angles. So, for example, meron tayong perpendicular line. So, nag-form siya ng, meron tayong line M at line N. So, nag-form siya ng 1, 2, 3, and 4 right angles. So, therefore, meron tayong right angles na 1, angle 2, angle 3, and angle 4. So, if M is perpendicular to N, then we can conclude that angle 1, angle 2, and angle 3, and angle 4 are right angles. Second theorem, if the angle in a linear pair are congruent, then the lines containing their sides are perpendicular. So again, meron tayong line, which is line sub 2 or L sub 2 at L sub 1. So, nag-form ito ng right angle. So, meron tayong angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, and angle 4. So, if angle 1 and angle 2 form a linear pair, and angle 1 is congruent to angle 2, then L sub 1 is perpendicular to L sub 2. So, kung ang angle 1 at angle 2 ay nag-form ng linear pair or nag-form ng straight line, katulad nito, and then ang sukat ng 1 at sukat ng 2 ay magkatulad or congruent sa isa't isa, therefore, or meaning, ang isang line ay perpendicular sa isa pang line. Third theorem, if two angles are adjacent and complementary, the non-common sides are perpendicular. So, meron tayong complementary angle, which is the complementary angle CAR and E. So, kung mapapansin nyo, ang letter L na angle na ito ay complementary since nag-form siya ng right angle or exactly 90 degrees. And then, hinati siya or ginawang dalawang angles. So, meron tayong adjacent angles or angles na magkatabi. So, if angle CAR and angle E, AR are complementary and adjacent, then segment AC is perpendicular to segment AE. So let us now summarize what we have learned about this lesson. Parallel lines or coplanar lines that do not intersect, the symbol for parallel is this one or yung dalawang lines. Perpendicular lines or lines that intersect at right angles, the symbol for perpendicular is that one. And then we have one parallel postulate. It states that there is exactly one line parallel to a line at a given point that contained on the line. And then we have three theorems on perpendicular lines. First, if two lines are perpendicular to each other, then they form four right angles. Second, if the angles in a linear pair are congruent, then the lines containing their sides are perpendicular. And the last, if two angles are adjacent and complementary, then non-common sides are perpendicular. Sana ay nakatulong ang video na ito sa inyong lesson. Thank you for watching. If you have questions or suggestions, feel free to comment below. Enjoy learning mathematics. God bless us all!